for the Monkey House, and that's right, we are right smack dab in the middle of this round of Let's Get Cookin', and big thank yous to Hans in Illinois, who moments ago designated our official recipe ingredient for the hour. Every one of our recipes in the test kitchens need to feature mango. That's right, Hans wanted a tropical flavor of the islands. What a delicious fruit. Mango, it's a lot of work, but it can lead to some delicious recipes. If you don't believe me, just stand back and listen to this. We've got three pint-sized celebrity chefs waiting in the wings to demonstrate their successful marriage of mango and mouth. Let's meet our first recipe creator now. All the way from Georgia, say hello, me Monkey Dots, to Miles. Hey, Miles, how are ya?
Good.
Great, welcome to the Monkey House, and thank you for lending your talents toward mango. Are you a fan of mango, Miles?
I've never tried it before, but I think I might be.
Oh, this is so exciting! So you've decided to sample mango for the first time by cooking with it. Wow. I mean, so it's a really sweet, sort of tropically flavored thing that looks like a really sweet orange avocado. It's so tasty. Oh, you're going to love it, Miles. Wow, this is really interesting. So you're coming up with a recipe having never tried it before. Tell us, Miles, what recipe did you invent?
I took the idea to get all of the ingredients from before and put them together one big thing. So it's mango wrapped in bacon with some and coconut water on the side and some broccoli.
Oh my gosh, this is amazing, audience. Miles is doing a show-long callback to all of our ingredients so far. Whoa, this is cool. Okay. So, of course, on today's Let's Get Cookin', in round one, we made ingredients into recipes, and that ingredient was bacon. In hour two, we did coconut. And in hour three, we almost were going to use broccoli. I mean, we were just moments away from using broccoli. We had two dialers joining us. It was Jack and Ava, who just for some reason we lost their call. But you've decided to take all these ingredients and mix them together with mango to make something brand new. Mango wrapped in bacon with coconut water on the side and a side of broccoli. How do you eat this? Do you eat it all together in one big bite? Or is this like different courses of the same meal, Miles?
Different courses of the same meal.
Oh,
so
I see. Okay.
I'll start with the bacon wrapped. I'll start with the mango that's wrapped in bacon. And then I would move on to the meat. And then I would finish it with a little drink of the coconut water.
Oh, this is great. Okay, so mango wrapped bacon, that gets you started. Or a bacon wrapped mango, excuse me. It's mango on the inside, bacon on the outside, right, Miles? Did I get that right?
Uh-huh.
Okay, good. I guess you could cut mango really thin and somehow wrap it around bacon, but that you'd need like a skewer to stick it all together. That sounds tough. This is a bacon wrapped mango. Then when you're done with that, you cleanse the palate with some delicious broccoli, and then wash the whole thing down with a side of coconut water. Audience, give it up for Miles in Georgia with the classic callback recipe. Oh man, that's a great one, Miles. Thank you for that. You really tied a ribbon around this whole show today, didn't you? Now let's go to California. And, we don't have to meet our next Epicurean. You know her, you love her. She's the producer of Live for the Monkey House and so much more. Audience, give it up for Scrambled Megs.
Hello.
Oh, hello, Scrambled Megs. I'm not sure why I always turn into Mrs. Doubtfire when I talk to you on air, but I did it again. Here I am, just cleaning up the kitchen in San Francisco. Scrambled Megs, I'm so happy you're here. Are you a fan of mango?
I am not particularly a fan of mango, actually.
Have you had it a lot and it never does it for you, or are you sort of uninitiated? Have you not eaten mango very much?
I like to try mango every once in a while just to make sure that I haven't somehow grown to like it and I didn't know.
I see. Okay. Oh, this makes sense. You just test yourself every once in a while to see whether your tastes have changed. And so far, mango is still on the do not call list. You're not you're not setting up play dates with mango. Well, maybe what it needs is your artistic touch, your artisanal chefery. This could be the moment the mango turns the corner for you. Tell us, Scrambled Bags, what recipe did you concoct?
I concocted a mango freeze.
Ooh. Is that an appropriate time to ooh? That just sounds like a good time to ooh.
It's
ooh.
Also an appropriate time to ah.
Tell us about the mango freeze.
Okay, well, first thing is I actually want to apologize and say I didn't make it up. It's a real thing.
Oh, okay. Hey, as long as you cite your sources, you can use it in your paper. That's fine. Just say where you got it.
Well, there's a time of year in my hometown of New Orleans, and there's a festival called Jazz Fest, and there's a lot of different food and good music. And one thing that my mom gets every year is mango freeze. And it's frozen mango with lime juice and condensed milk or sweet milk. And it's frozen up in a little ball, and you get it in a cup, and everyone loves it.
Oh, my gosh. Wait, so it's, like, frozen solid, or is it, like, a slushy kind of consistency?
It's, like, frozen solid, like, kind of like sorbet.
Oh, I see. Ice cream. Oh, and then you eat it with a spoon, like you scrape it off of there.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, wow, that's really fun. So, famously, Harry Nilsson tried to put the lime in the coconut and was never successful, but with the mango freeze, you can put the lime in the mango. Wow.
Ooh,
very tasty. Oh, but hey, now I get the you and the ah. Listen, maybe you could set up a mango freeze stand there at Venice Beach, like next to Muscle Beach while everyone's working out in California.
Oh,
maybe this could be your thing.
I'll have my cousin Cooper help me set up a stand.
Whoa, I've talked to that guy. He's a surfer, right?
Yeah, he's a surf instructor.
Okay, yeah. He's part of the larger Monkey House universe, the MHU. Well, audience, give it up for Scrambled Megs' Mango Freeze! And actually, Scrambled Megs, now can I tell you about my recipe that I created with mango? Well, earlier on today's show, we were making some food out of bacon. And famously, I think it was Lady Gaga who created a dress entirely out of bacon, if I'm not mistaken.
Mm-hmm.
You can turn bacon into all kinds of things. So I was wondering, I wonder if you could make something that's edible, but also wearable, out of mango. And that's how I created this, the mango headband.
Wow.
Yeah, thank you. I'm wearing it right now.
It looks fabulous.
When I'm wearing it, I look sort of like a 1980s era Andre Agassi, the tennis star. You wear this headband. It's made exclusively out of mango on your forehead. It wraps around really tight around the back. And what happens is if you go outside and you're doing any sort of athletic activity, anything that makes you sweat a little bit, your sweat co-mingles with the mango and drips down. And when it gets to your mouth, you don't taste that gross, salty sweat. You taste delicious mango. So that incentivizes you to exercise and keep working out, you know, like run an extra mile, get a little bit more of that mango flavor in there. And bonus, when you're all done, you can peel the mango headband off your head and your body temperature cooked it. So it's crisp like bacon. What do you think?
Wow, forgetting about an Apple Watch, it's all about the mango headband.
Very nice. All right, hey, Tim Cook at Apple or anyone else in the Apple Corporation, I'm willing to make this the iMango headband. You just give me a call. You know the number, 1-866-328-2345. Audience, what do you think about my invention? It's the mango headband. And it does, all of your apps work on it, by the way. All your iOS apps work. Well, there you go, everyone. Those are the three recipes that feature mango. And now we need one brave Epicurean taste tester to try each one of these mango recipes and tell us their flavor. That's right, we've got mango that's wrapped in bacon with a side of broccoli and wash it down with some coconut water. We've got the delicious imported from New Orleans, Louisiana mango freeze. And we've got my functional, utilitarian, and delicious mango headband.